Like, big balling with my homies. The fuck you know about it. You know what I mean?
Big 310. You
already know.
Big Lokes in the car, brother.
Put that on a fucking, who's that fool? Posse's on Broadway. Sir Mix-a-Lot beat. Fucking E40 rapping on it. Big ball with my homies, bro. What you know? You already know.
We are the future of fools.
I heard it was 310. We'll get two zip pairs.
Oh, yes.
I actually never thought about that. I did notice that, though.
We are Fried Smooths from San Pedro. I'm Eli. I play bass and sing.
I'm JP. I play guitar and also sing.
I'm Anthony. I'm on the drums.
Yessah.
So we'll just moan.
These two knew each other first.
Yeah, it kind of came towards the end of our old band, Anthony and I's old band, Unexpected Fetus. And we knew we wanted to start a new project, but we wanted to keep it local, Pedro style. So, you know, knew JP was from Pedro. We knew he ripped that guitar. It only made sense. Yeah, we just hit him up and he was down.
Yeah, pretty much. We've been like jamming since.
Yes.
And we've been like, how long have we been playing? For like 2022, maybe?
Yeah, that's what we were trying to figure out this day. Yeah, probably like 2022-ish, I think.
It was like when my hair was like blonde with the two strips laid
out. Yeah, yeah, the skunk look.
Yeah,
it's around that time. Yeah, something like that. So yeah, probably like 2 years, I would say.
About that, we're hitting it.
Yeah. Shit, I guess we go one by one. You go first, Brad.
I don't know, it's kind of like hard for me to like pick up on like the little things when it comes to reggae artists, but my understanding of the genre is kind of like what influences how I play, like upstrokes, a lot of dead notes and things like that, using kind of like more chords and shit than like traditional punk, I guess, and also which bleeds into more punk songs too, use of like more chords, how I play, things like that, and try to be like kind of more like experimental with it in a sense, kind of think of like maybe Minutemen-ish, not to get like ultra loaded on it.
Econo style, Econo.
Yeah.
Yeah, personally for me, I don't know, I've always kind of just played like this kind of like ska punk blend, but obviously different degrees. I sucked when I started and I'm not that good now, but I got more of a grasp on it. I like kind of like heavy dub bass lines mixed with like some fast riffs and, you know, obviously the walking bass lines. We got some new stuff in the works. It's going to sound pretty fire, I would say. But yeah.
Man, I listen to everything. Oh, yeah. Right. All of that.
Yeah, we like to try new things, trying to kind of like to keep people on their toes. Obviously, I don't think that many people from like the local punk scene are that into ska, but we kind of we'll mix it in with a little fucking breakdown, a little like quick riff, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
Try to get some action going.
Yeah, we throw a little like hardcore influences and shit, especially more on the breakdowns. Kind of like how we go for the more ska core style and shit with it.
Yes.
Like just kind of make it a little heavier than like normal ska punk would be, you know? Think kind of like, I think a good example, like I've shown, like I've made these dudes listen to these two bands, this band from the East Bay, Link 80.
Oh, yeah.
From like late 90s or early 2000s, and like same time period, Cap Down, this British band they did a split with, kind of like just ska, regular ska punk, you know, with, like ska and fast like punk, but heavy is like real like more atypical hardcore stylings to it too.
Yeah, JP really personally put me on with that shit. It was pretty sick. I like both those bands, but also from my end, I really like Voodoo Glow Skulls is a pretty sick band. They're like from around the 90s, I think, but I really dug that because they were playing like really fast and hard ska. And they're like Latino homies, so you know, they mix in the Spanish, and I really fucked with that. Also like Ocho Calaca, same thing, heavy ska core. They're more like metal, but you know, the feeling's still there. And we talked about this, we came up with our own thing. We like to call it no-tone ska, because we don't play punk right, we don't play ska right, we just play our own way, man.
Yeah. This is very localized.
Yep. It's whatever comes, whatever flows.
Just let it rip, you know? Honestly, it's kind of just like, I don't know, because it's a different experience attending a show versus playing it. Like, attending is kind of like different, but they also have their own similarities. Like, it's like they're very parallel, where like crowd participation is different, but something's very common, you know, where you're hanging out, you're having a good time, you're kicking back type shit. But like, I'd say honestly, like, my favorite is kind of just simply playing, you know, and like the fact that people are there and they enjoy it, it just makes it cooler.
Oh yeah, my favorite part about at these shows is just doing the music tasks. It's just fun. I like running little things.
Doing a bit of the music.
Doing so many music tasks.
Yeah, I like, I know, I generally like playing music, especially with these fools. Like, we got some good chemistry. It's always fun. We're always on, like, we're just always in the same groove. We got it locked in. But I really dig, like, you know, obviously when people slam, like, you know, it took a minute because we were like a younger band. But now we got a little more action, you know what I'm saying? People are starting to dig our sound. I think it's pretty rad seeing a little skank, a little shove, you know, whatever. Just have a good time. That's what it's all about. I personally, I grew up mainly listening, like Corridos and Bandla, whatever. But I did have this Theo who, he would always take us to the beach, and he had this CD, this very distinct CD. It was called the Red Truck Playlist, because he had a red truck, and it had a bunch of, like, reggae and dub and ska on it. So I was probably, like, I was a grom. I was probably, like 8 or 9, like, probably earlier than, like, 7 is my earliest memory of that. So I was listening to that for a while. But honestly, I didn't really get into, like, punk and hardcore until I started skating, until I was, like, I want to say 12, 13. And, like, I remember one of the first bands, just because, like, Solomon Thrasher was, like, suicidal, and, you know, it's... I was, like, fell in love with it, and then eventually, you know, you find out about, like, the ska punk bands, ska core bands, it's just a perfect blend of everything. Then, like, I really fucking, I love Bad Brains, like, from a young age, too, is one of the earlier ones as well, because I really did the whole dub and hardcore thing, like, the blend, really sick, like, obviously, this is probably played out, but I love that CBGB's clip of them playing, and, like, they'll be playing, like, super gnarly song, like, Regulator, I, and then straight into, like, the I and I Survive, or...
I love
some,
Ija.
Yeah, so I love Ija, some stuff like that, just heavy.
Yeah, fucking growing up, my parents played like gangster rap, fucking reggae and like oldies and shit. So I was always kind of exposed to reggae, but not in a very deep sense. Very much sort of service level, like Bob Marley, like Peter Tosh, shit like that. Now, not that they're bad, you know, but like my dad and like I didn't really pick up on this until I was older and shit. But like him and some of his brothers, they're more into punk shit, right? Like most of them are. Like half of them, so they'd burn CDs back when that was popular. And just one day, like, my mom was playing one of them in the car, and it was just caught my eye, and it was Operation Ivy. And because I got into ska, then through ska I got into punk and shit, and that's how it kind of like came to be. Ska was like the first love, and still is
lit. I was always into like little bits of everything since I was a kid. Always been put on from my like my family. They used to have parties at my house, have the backyard going lit. So I got lots of kinds of music. But like in the hardcore like community around here, and like the hardcore shows, yeah, I didn't get into that until like definitely around like high school. Definitely, I was in high school.
I was like middle school. I was like 7th grade, I want to say.
Big look dog. Cool. Yeah, I was like high school as well. Just like, I didn't really have social media until I got into high school, so I didn't really know about anything. Yeah, yeah, and then I figured out and started hitting some shows.
Yeah, I got tapped in locally. I was at San Pedro, like my freshman year of high school, like fucking 2017 or some shit. The Growlers, this one kind of psychedelic band, they had a festival. They have a festival every year, and they had it in San Pedro. We were from that year, and I went, and I met a fool from this local band at the time, 1034, and he gave me their flyers, and that's how I got tapped in. And like, you know, I didn't have like social media till high school, you know, so I just wasn't like tapped in like that. And it kind of just, that was another springboard off from that point.
Hell yeah. This fool seemed like you got one.
Dude, I don't remember if Fried Smooth played this one. It was a Peck Park show. And I know for sure Piss played it, but I don't remember if we played the same night or not.
Was it the one we Deviated?
Was it the one at Rain? Did we play that one?
Where
it rained?
Yeah, we opened.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Fucking, it was after the show, me and my bandmate from my former band Piss were cleaning up and shit, kind of like just being, just trying to be respectful. And there's just these two people fucking on a park bench, fully clothed.
I remember you guys told me about
like,
that.
Dude, it was like, no one else existed. Like, nothing existed but them. They were going at it, bro. And there's just, they didn't notice shit. They even noticed the show was over, bro. Me and the homie, we just stopped cleaning after that, and we just left. We're like, you know, we're gonna leave him be. We're gonna give him some privacy.
It's fucking intimacy, bro.
Raw-ass public fucking broke, fully clothed, awful.
That's pretty heavy.
This isn't that wild, but I do think it was kind of like, I don't want to say like I guess, unique. It was just, like, random. But I remember we played that one of the first Pink Palace shows was for the dog or something. And there was, like, mid-set, just, like, three dogs just ran out of the house and were just, like, scampering around, like, like through the pit and stuff. I was like, whoa, I was like, what's going on here, dude? I was like, fuck, hopefully no steps on these fools. But yeah, honestly, yeah, I feel like as of late, it's kind of been tame. Like, you know, just casual show stuff. How about you, dude?
Man, the craziest thing I ever saw at a show gives the same answer as another interview I've done. No, man. See, every show is crazy.
Crazy.
And I've been hit in the head at so many of them, I can hardly remember them.
I've been there.
No.
Classic.
But nope. I've seen some crazy shit. I've seen, like, big foos straight crowd dive and like knock into like five people's heads, and it's just funny.
Pretty classic.
I've seen like little, like smaller stature people get fucking clotheslined. Oh, awful, bro.
Shout out T-Note.
No, you know what I thought was funny? We were playing that 4th of July show, and then those knucklehead cats, they had like the gnarly green smoke, and I couldn't see shit, like, because people were trying to skate and slam. I was like, alright, fucking, this is sick, but at the same time, I'm gonna eat shit right now.
Oh, yeah, we played a show on a half pipe.
Yeah, that was one of the better shows for me. That was a really sick experience.
That was actually a pretty cool one.
Yeah, people just ripping on the half pipe. So, yeah, that goes down there on the list.
Yeah, there's fools actually hitting shit while we're playing on the half pipe. That was cool.
Yeah, some fool hit like a blunt to fakie. That was pretty heavy. Some Grom did like a little fucking front D. That was sick. Super. Someone, no, wait, so during that show, I remember like a pit started, someone jumped off of the roof, like, into the pit. I just saw someone go, boom, I was like, oh shit. Yeah. But yeah, that's pretty funny. Yeah, that was a sick one right there. A good little time.
Yeah. I know I hit that ramp while another band was playing.
Oh yeah, you got to. Yeah.
That's weird, just weird at
Sherman. Yeah, Sherman and Gina. You gotta interview those cats one day.
Yeah, one day. They like, most local bands wouldn't, like, exist without them.
They carry...
Word of the wise.
They literally carry the scene on their back.
They just built like that. They're sturdy. Yeah. Ooh. I think that's kind of a good... That's an interesting question, because in the sense of the 80s, and the way of punk being misrepresented as at the times it was, I think it's also misrepresented now, but in a different way. While there, they kind of... In the 80s, kind of more pinpointed, like... misrepresented, like scrutinized very specific points, almost cherry picking. Now, punk and similar and like parallel like subcultures, they're all kind of blanketed under all kind of, at least they were for a period.
Yeah. Everyone thinks they're fucking punk. Everyone thinks they're all this shit.
They're kind of just all like, people seem as the same thing, and it's really not. And it's kind of like a little distinction thing. It's kind of like, what's the word? It's almost like having perfect pitch. It's kind of like, you gotta have an ear and eye for it to see the difference, you know what I mean?
Oh yeah, this guy's fucking
and
real.
And because that, people like, you know, lump shit into hashtags and have all these preconceptions about that. Like, I saw this thing on social media, I'm not sure if it's like a real consistent pattern, but someone saying like, hey, to be like all, do you have to like not shower and brush your teeth? And I'm just like, what the fuck are you talking about? I was showering and brushed my teeth, I still fucking do.
Yeah, exactly.
And they're like, all my friends said they don't. I'm like, no, it's kind of like another way of spreading misinformation, and like,
I will say a lot of punks are stinky.
They are, and it's not that it's an old trend, but it's like hit a new uprise now. Like, it's hitting unprecedented levels. Yeah, like, sure. I think I have to call the CDC next week. I'm considering it. You know,
not the crusties. Oh no,
not the grind kids.
I feel like, because when we started, we didn't have an Instagram for a while. We were just playing shows.
Yeah. Our first couple were just nothing. They were like, you're just like, oh yeah, these are other shows that we already played.
Yeah, exactly. So it definitely helped us to, like, maybe get hit up more, I guess. It was just easier to contact us, because if not, you just had to, like, DM us, but...
Yeah, and social media does make things more centralized, too. It's kind of, like, easier to look around, because if you don't know the band, you can find their personal, or, like, someone who's played with them, ask them how they got in the contact. I don't know, it just has kind of its drawbacks. Like, in an organizing sense, it's very beneficial, but in a social sense, it's kind of detrimental, and not at the same time, but, you know... Give or take.
Yeah, like, we got a lot of new people coming to the scene, which is sick, but at the same time, a lot of these fools are just fucking kooks, for lack of a better term. They just don't really know how it goes down. They're kind of, like, just blowing it at the shows, being, like, over the top. Like, I get, like, you know, trying to have a good time and stuff, but just, you know, just don't be a fucking dick. But, I don't know, it's like a blessing and a curse, social media. Like, more expansion, more coverage, I would say. Like, people could find you easier. But then, like, the drawback is, like, I don't know. A lot of bands try to have, like, a certain aesthetic, and that kind of bothers me personally.
Yeah. It's like, also, social media, it's another way to just portray a very two-dimensional image of something.
Yeah.
And, like, with that, it kind of... I went to the NAMM show recently, and it's, like, essentially, like, a big convention for the music industry, right? And, like, one of the things I... Because they have seminars and other along with other shit, one of the things they're never saying is that... And one of the ones I attended, it was, like... Bands, you know, they could either be, like, really good on social media, you know, but, like, a live show or their music, it kind of just, like, doesn't match up to the same level. I think that could be a drawback, too, to it, you know? Like... When people who don't know have this preconception of punk, going back to that, you know, mm-hmm. see this person on social media who looks like it, but their music is not punk at all. It's just, for lack of better phrasing, some poser bullshit. Just some,
yeah. Fools would listen to Coldplay and have like a leather jacket on or something.
They'd be saying some. They'll like liken one band is like, oh, this is punk rock, but it's like kind of, but like it's really not. So it's like someone saying like, oh, Green Day's punk rock. Like, yeah, sure, but like my American Idiot, that's so punk rock. It's like I wouldn't say the same. It's kind of like that too. It's a lot. Social media is very much about images. It's a very two-dimensional thing. You don't see what's really going on, and that's kind of like the drawback. You don't have the in. It's not in depth.
At the same time, like, you know, photos and vids can make you look cool. Like a lot of bands, like, just post certain clips per se or certain pictures because they look sick. But you know, you see them live, and it's not as sick as it looks to be on like Instagram or whatever. And I just feel like you just gotta keep the energy all the time, no matter if there's a fucking camera pointed at you or not. Just like. Keep it intense, keep it wild. I mean, if that's your thing, if you're more of like a posted up player, then that's cool too, you know? I mean, do your thing. Just keep it original.
Yeah. I'd say social media for this band is just like a big group chat to let everybody know when the next show is.
Yeah, pretty much.
Yeah.
That's pretty much like all social media is, like, for a band's functional point, it's another point of contact and networking.
Yeah, pretty much. So email us at... Wait, friedsmooth310@gmail.com.
Yeah.
Email us for shows, bro.
And if you want to send us weed, let us know. We'll get a P.O. box.
These guys. I am America's straight edge myself. I only drink beer.
Hell yeah, brother.
Coining that one.
Hell yeah.
I feel like I kind of have the same things in my roto. It's usually like Desmond Dekker's always on there, like an OG ska legend. And I really dig, let me see here, let me think. I like a lot of, like, the more, like, I like a lot of the 90s stuff. Like, this is gonna sound corny as fuck, but I really don't care. I fucking love Sublime, like, big fucking home dogs. Or obviously not my home dogs, but you know what I mean? Like, they're loped out from Long Beach. Shit's sick. I'm trying to think. What else? I like Choking Victim a lot. They're pretty rad. I get a lot of influence from those fools. But, also been listening to more, like, some dark wave stuff. Just getting in touch with my dark side, man. Nah, but for real, like... I have been getting more into that. My girlfriend put me on that shit, so shout out to Michelle. She showed me a lot of that stuff, which is sick. But yeah, I mean, they just fucking ska, dub. I'm trying to think. Lately, for like punk wise, I kind of always revert back to RKO, their Rippers. The Mainliners are pretty sick. They got a couple of good jams, like some more contemporary cats. Yeah.
I don't know, newer bands I've been checking out was like these kind of two hardcore bands. Like, their name, one is, oh my god, I was listening the fucking other day. They're sick. They're like this thrashy hardcore band. They're fucking, if I remember, I'll bring it up, but throwbacks, I've been listening to Suicidal Tendencies and Fear and the Ramones a lot lately. Like, on some old shit, like on some youth nostalgia type beat. Yeah, man. Oh, and Lou Reed's Rock and Roll Animal. That's one of the greatest live albums of all time. I've been listening to that a lot lately. And the bands were Cruel Force and Fugitive. Those are two new bands.
Oh, Fugitive's pretty sick.
That are pretty fucking sick.
Yeah. Lit.
What you been listening to, Anthony?
Man, I've been listening to, like, low-key reggae, straight up.
Straight up.
So many bands, like... What am I going to do? List all these artists? like, look up, like, a reggae playlist, bro. Like, come on now. It got that beat in it. Yeah, dude.
Yeah, groove. It grooving.
That's all you need, Casa.
White boy reggae. I'm going to a reggae fest, the Cali vibes. Oh yeah.
Long dicky shorts.
Pretty much flops. Like the One Love fest if it was like, you know, the white boy reggae. You know, they got some classes hidden in though.
You're gonna see Pepper that day, right? Or not?
I don't know.
Damn. Shout out Barrington Levy. I've always listened to that shit forever in my heart. That shit's rad.
Yessah.
But also, there's this one band I've listened to a lot recently. They're like a skate punk band. They're called Los Olvidados. They're from San Jose. Like older, I don't know what. I want to say 80s. Like 80s, right? Yeah.
80s.
It was like a couple of just rippers who like just play some sick skate punk. And I love, they have like one album. Or they have like a bunch of like different releases, but there's like one like compilation that's pretty sick with everything.
Yeah. A cumbia group called, I think it's Lalom, I think it's pronounced.
Ah.
A lot of their shit is like, and he's already like existing songs, but they're cool. Their recordings are good.
Oh yeah. Cultured man, bro.
Hey, dude, a lot of LA ska bands like cumbia, dude.
No, yeah, like Shout La Muerte there. These fools are sick. They're from the Harbor area. They play like ska and cumbia and hardcore, a mix of all that. It's pretty sick. I love that band, to be honest.
Yeah, they're rivers.
There's like
La
Pobresca. Oh yeah.
Catacomb Rockers too. They're cool. A little more rockabilly, that's your thing, but excellent band.
Yeah, excellent. I'm trying to think, yeah. Some B-dubs, some Beach Waves, I said last shit. Always go back to the Bad Sex on my phone.
It's a classic, honestly.
Yeah, sick. Yeah, so it's too much to name, honestly.
Yeah, it's kind of a lot. it depends on the day.
Yeah.
Yeah. Lots of the local homies.
Yeah, for sure.
For sure. Always.
Shout out them. New Mad EPs goes pretty hard.
Real straight big beacon.
Yeah, literally. It's fucking heavy. But yeah.
They let it swing with it. You know what I mean? You ever seen X? You know the scene I'm talking about.
Precisely, bro. Precisely.
Okay, a band I've been listening to that's newer that I think is really good in my personal taste is this band. I want to say they're from St. Louis or somewhere in the Midwest. They're called MS Paint. They have no guitar, bass, drums, vocals, and some dude like on synth, keyboard, shit like that.
Heavy.
It's very interesting. It's new. I don't really know any really other groups that like them, but their new album, Post American, is pretty good by MS Paint.
Oh, yeah.
I gotta say, listen to Mad.
Hey.
Straight up, listen to Mad. M-A-D-D.
With the
Mad. Period.
They got periods in between the letters.
Period, yeah, the acronym guys.
Straight out of Carson.
What you know about it?
Harbor area. Yep.
Like, for me, I already brought up La Muerte, but I listen to La Muerte a lot. They're pretty sick. Shout out the 310 style. There's one band I gotta see. I found them the other day.
He's gotta do his research.
Yeah, let me pull up the fucking link.
What you got going on here? Oh my gosh, I just saw his playlist. I'm about to have like the best soundtrack ever.
I think they're called like MPH, Miles Per Hour. Hold on. Yeah, Miles Per Hour. They're pretty, I don't know where the fuck they're from. I literally found them like yesterday. That's pretty sick. Little fucking classic punk. It's pretty sick.
They say this shit on the bottom.
Nah, it doesn't say anything. 13 listeners, tell you know it's good. But yeah, they're pretty sick. I don't know where the fuck they're from, but MPH, they're rad.
If no one listens to the band, they must be good. Remember that.
Yes, yeah, exactly. Below 100 listeners, you're on. But aside from that, I love Beach Waves. Whenever I can see them, I always catch those homies, you know.
Excellent band.
Even outside the shows, we'll skate, surf, whatever, but these guys are locked in. They're rad.
They're gamers.
I got one off the top of my head, and JP knows about this. This is the old band, like older, like 90s, but Falling Idols, they're from Long Beach, some surf punks.
They're 80s.
Oh, 80s? Fuck yeah, I'm not good with the time, whatever. The 80s, 90s, some fucking bullshit. But yeah. But yeah, I have Falling Idols from Long Beach, surf punks, I should say.
Yeah, Sublime stole their self-titled song. It's not by them, guys. Just look up Falling Idols' self-titled album on YouTube, you'll find their shit.
Yeah, it's prime, dude.
And a band I think is underrated, gotta keep it local, PDW. They don't get enough recognition, absolutely.
Yessah.
Yeah.
Those guys are rippers, actually. Shout out Andres, all those fools.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
And Deviated State.
Yeah.
The best underground band, because they are, but they're everywhere.
Here. Yeah, those fools have been around forever, and they're rippers.
They're the kings of the local, honestly.
Yeah, most of
those cats.
In here in the Harbor area, they're like everywhere. They're crazy.
Everywhere and nowhere at the same time.
They're in the air, bro.
Yessah.
And that phone you're watching from, wherever the fuck they're in that shit right now, too.
Yeah, just look it up. YouTube, PDW, bruh.
Writing new songs, honestly, to then record and then release and write more.
Yeah, that's pretty much it, yeah. We're working on some stuff. Got a couple new songs. We play them live, but we also got a few we're still working on.
A couple.
Yeah, we got like a handful, yeah. Who knows, maybe we'll drop a single sometime. Who knows, you know, maybe. Who knows. But we do have some merch en route, actually. We got some pins and patches. I don't know when this is going to be dropped, but they might be out by the time the thing comes out. You got to just come see us and find out.
It's moving like a turtle.
Yeah.
It's Shirley.
Yeah, shout out to the homie Seth for making this.
Yeah.
Me fucking.
Shout out Pulse Check Distro.
Yeah, those ones are actually printing it, but the homie Seth made this big South Bay look. That one's sick. We got a fucking little preview of this guy, little alt. No Tone Rude Boy, bruh. Los Rudos. We're on. Yeah, that's pretty much it. Writing music, jamming, playing shows, coming out with merch. Finally, we've been lacking on it. Yeah.
We've been starving you for too long, you know?
Had to do it to him. Oh, shit. I hope. Well, I'm an optimist. Like, I plan to keep jamming with these fools. Like, plan to keep Fry Smooth pumping, release more music, play more shows, you know?
Yeah.
Maybe book another tour. We did do a tour last, what was it, summer?
Yeah, we played a couple shows in the Bay Area in Santa Cruz.
Santa Cruz, SF.
That shit was sick. Cool.
Yeah. Hopefully we can book a bigger one.
Cool. That scene up there is like LA straight up, where it's like, the Bay Area, like, around the, like, the media Bay Area, you know, like, north, south, east and shit, and, like, San Jose, Santa Cruz, it's just, like, SoCal, where each they got their own little sections and shit, and we barely only played, like, more southern SF around, like, Mission, was it?
Yeah, I think it was the meat, something, meat, the Tenderloin,
Was it the Tenderloin?
I think so.
Well, wherever
the Thrill House.
Thrill House Records.
Wherever Session SF Thrill House is at, that area is cracking. Santa Cruz is just kind of loped out. It's a sleepy beach town, honestly. Yeah, dude, not bad though. Cool place.
Yeah, I went to school there. It was all right. You know, it was rad. You know, I kicked it with the skaters, man. There were some good shows there, like some good punk bands that rolled through, some dub reggae. But yeah, I mean, we played the spot called the Sabrosa. The place is pretty sick. A nice little compact area.
Little communist, cool spot.
Yeah,
little
anarchism.
Anarchism.
I'm just kidding. But yeah. But yeah, just in general, if I can just, you know, keep grinding.
Keep it moving, know what I mean? Don't stop.
Working. We like to lurk in the shadows, bruh. Can't tell you too much.
Real G's moving silence like lasagna.
Yes, so, you know.
Cool, young breezy, or whatever the fuck people call him.
You'll be seeing us around. You'll be seeing more Fried Smooth.
You might see me at work. You might not.
Yeah, you might.
Who's? See this. Not sure.
Yes,
the only real plan is to keep up the music.
Yeah, that's all real. Yeah, that's honestly what we got right now.
We have a guideline.
We gotta be perpetually stoked. That's the guideline, cousin. Just fucking stoked at all times, no matter what. Keep jamming, keep holding it down. I feel like, personally, I don't know if it's a revival, like, it's always been here, you know what I mean? Like, you just gotta look for it.
Yeah, I agree with what Eli said, but revival's not necessarily wrong either. It's just for reference, you know, like, there's a, in historical terms, to talk about the revival, at least in America, there's like a spiritual religious revival in the United States in like the 1800s. I don't remember the exact decade. You know, Christianity still existed, but wasn't the same, you know, until that revival happened. I think that's like what makes revival correct, but it's cool because when I started going to shows, like around 2016, it was kind of on its way out in a sense. It's very small and insular, and you got to be really want to get into it if you were going to get into it. Know what I mean? You know, like, there's kind of, like, cross-bleeding from, like, the indie crowd and stuff, because that was prevalent at the time. And, like, along with the kind of, like, stuff happening to, like, in the indie scene and kind of its dissolvement around, like, right before COVID, too, is kind of, like, I think a good amount of people shifted as well. But, like, it's not a bad thing. It's kind of, like, in the same sense where, like, or parallel to, like, the late 70s, where it's very small and insular, then hardcore punk came around and started getting more in the media and the news, in the similar way I was kind of blowing up on social media too. A lot of people are coming in, but also, you know, there's posers and bullshit and people who really want to get into it, but people who don't, they think they got a grasp and they don't. It's kind of, I don't know, history does repeat, but it sure as hell fucking rhymes, you know?
Yeah. Also, I'd like to add that, like, I feel like just the time space, like, just this age, just kind of like the central feeling of, like, at least what I feel around, like, I don't know, like, a fucking America, but like, just like society in general. A lot of the youth are just restless, you know, we want something new, want something rad, something raw. That's just what we're trying to do. We're trying to, honestly, we're just trying to bring it about ourselves. That's the only thing you can do. You can't really rely on other people. You just gotta, you know, start your own band, do your own thing.
Yeah.
Do what makes you happy. But yeah, I feel like there's a revival in that sense. Everyone just like, just waiting for something new to pop up, something sick, something to get stoked on.
Yeah, it's kind of just but saying that you gotta make it happen. You gotta get stoked.
DIY, fat guys, remember that.
Yeah. Your grandma's garage, bro, she's going on vacation. Throw everything out, sell it, throw a show.
Yeah, there you go.
Your work's closing, tell your boss to make some last free, tax-free fucking money, throw a show. You got some dudes to play in a band, but only for one show, do it.
Yeah, fuck it, doesn't even matter. It doesn't even have to be a gnarly crowd, as long as the music's sick, fuck yeah. As long as you're having a good time, that's all that matters, man.
Fuck yeah. Even setting up a show, just pull up somewhere and play and piss off the public.
It's, fuck, dude, we've done that enough times.
Hell yeah, man. Dude.
So I can play wherever you can, whenever you can, however you can. Wait, did I already say that? Nah, it
doesn't matter. Doesn't matter.
Yep.
Be here again.
Yes, sir. That's a good question.
We played a show. It was like in this stinky, stinky place.
Which one?
Ugh. Remember the one that was at the underpass, except it was like one of the later ones.
Oh, yeah. The last one we played.
Dude, the last underpass show we played. Honestly, all the other ones were pretty sick, but this last one, like, there were already a bunch of homeless cats living there, but now it was like,
there's a lot more.
There's a lot more. It's like a fucking encampment. But anyways, I think we played next to their fucking quote-unquote bathroom, which is like a ditch where they shit in, and it just smelled like terrible, dude. It was fucking gnarly.
There was also a sex toy down there somewhere.
Oh, remember yeah.
That? Wasn't that like a butt plug or
yeah,
some shit?
Yeah, some anal beads, some butt plugs. It's supposed to get freaky down there, but...
Yeah, we're getting out a good time, yeah. You know?
We just had to carry our gear past, yeah. Like, don't step on that.
Yeah, fucking gnarly hill.
Miss me on that fecal matter, bro. We also played two shows that night, too, actually.
Oh, yeah, we played that one in Long Beach, oh, and we went yeah. To Compton. That little spot was sick.
Yeah.
Little restaurant.
The food was not bad, either.
Yeah, it's just sick. Fuck, all I gotta say is fucking hit us up for shows, yeah. Listen to our music, bruh. Thank you to those who do listen to music. Keep skating, keep shredding, keep surfing, keep doing whatever you do that makes you happy. Stay fried, bruh. Yeah, cousin. Shout out to Pedro. Shout out to all the Pedro homies, the Pedro family. Wouldn't be anything without them, to be honest. Pedro, got a special place in my heart.
Shout out to the local sunken city. You already know. It's funny that's considered a tourist attraction on Google, but legally you're not supposed to fucking enter.
Yeah.
But still advertised. I love it.
I will say this. It kind of bugs me when people that... When bands are from Pedro take pictures of Sunken City, I think that's just... It doesn't bug me, but I think it's funny.
It's funny. Non-lokes, yeah. Straight.
Oh, yeah.
Dude, you know you ever heard that one band, The Black Lips? They're like an indie band.
Yeah, dude. That's
what
yeah, okay.
You're thinking of?
Yeah, okay, yes. Because I listened to one of their songs, I was looking at the album, I was like, dude, this is for sure Sunken City. And then I like, they're not even from, like, I don't even know if they're from California, I don't know where they're from, but.
I don't think so, dude. Yeah. I saw them, I think, one time.
Right on.
But fucking, oh yeah, dude, fucking Last Gen did a photo there, too.
Nah, fuck, those are the homies.
They're locals.
Yeah, those guys are
cool,
yeah.
Shout out Last Gen. Fucking. Yeah. Yeah, I don't know. Start a band, start their own shows, do shit like that. If you don't want to do music, then do something else.
Like a zine. Oh, yeah. Interview homies like our big dog back here. Shout out Lalo.
Yeah.
Fucking.
Yeah. More people like Lalo, honestly. Yeah. But, you know, you can't top him, though. Don't try.
Yeah, this guy is fucking single-handedly documenting the whole SBHA scene. Sorry, yeah. Shout out fucking Gina. Out there.
She's checking
holding
on
it
us.
Down.
Yeah.
If you ever need a spot to jam, hit up Sideshow, Sherman and Gina.
Gardena, California.
I think we already said this earlier, but they literally carried the scene on their back. A lot of sick bands come down here. But shout out to them. That's a big shout out. We always jam here.
Yeah, the big carry. Like, we do not understand.
Yeah. That's it.
Oh, fucking. Man, off the bat, fucking. All the locals and the homies, you know, and shit, who put us on our first couple shows and just pulled up and, like, played with us and just supporting and being friends and shit like that.
Yeah, fucking. I mean, honestly, the list is so long. We've already named a few.
We can name basically... We can name half the world, you know?
Yeah. Shout out all the locals. You guys know who you are. We played shows with you guys countless times. We kick it with you fools outside of shows, so it really doesn't matter. Shout out to all the fucking... friends and family who pull up to the show, you know what I mean? Shout out to those fools.
Oh, yeah.
And fans, too, you know, keep it 3Fs or whatever.
Yeah, to the fucking followers, the fucking social media followers. We do it for you. It's all for you guys.
For the fried youth.
Yeah, fucking stay fried, fools. But, Yeah, it's mainly it, just a local scene. Shout out to everyone who puts this on, Blaster Music. You know, mainly it. I feel like we already named a bunch of bands with our just the music we listen to, and like half of that stuff was already local.
Yeah. Yeah.
We're localists if you can't tell.
You guys know who you are. The locals, you fools fucking know. Shout out to the homies, SBHA for life. Por vida, faca.
Yeep. Well, I mean, if you're already rolling, fucking let's keep it rolling. Yeah, thanks for fucking watching. You know, thanks for supporting us and shit from the times we played into the future and all that. Your support's appreciated. You guys want to be a pal, you know, buy a beer, offer a cigarette, yeah. Fucking offer some weed. We might offer likewise back, maybe. I might offer you weed. I'm not going to give you a beer, though, being honest.
Regulator, yeah. Big beer hoarder, but
yeah, don't be drinking driving, guys. That's
yeah,
stupid.
That's a big thing, dude. Don't be a fucking idiot. But like I said, like JP said, thank you to all our supporters out there, everybody who ever put us on, all those who listen to our music. Look out for the merch drop. We're gonna have some stuff eventually, pretty soon, at our next shows. Just you know, keep listening to our music. Thank you so much for all the love and support. Just stay local. That's all I gotta say, guys.
Localize, brother. Think globally, act locally.
Yes, sir.
How's it back up with 5-2, San Pedro? This is 4-2, Connor Ziz. I'm gonna go to the party.
Forming by the germs, the dope side.